Let's talk about quadratic functions. A function of type y equals to f of x equals x square ax square plus bx plus c, where this a is non-zero, is called a quadratic function. A should not be equal to zero. If a equals to zero, then this becomes a linear function. Okay. Now, this function can be written in a standard form, which is y equals to f of x equals to a x minus h whole square plus k, right? Where this h is simply negative b over 2a and k is f of h. So this f of h means f of negative b over 2a. If we write in this way, then most of the problem for quadratic function will be solved easily. Then what we would like to note down is from this standard form is that the first one is a. If the leading coefficient a is greater than zero, the curve would be something just like this. It opens upward. If a is less than zero, the curve will open downwards. It will be something just like dome-like shape. This will be the curve. Vertex. The highest point when a is less than zero or the lowest point of the curve when a is greater than zero is known as vertex. Okay. The vertex is h, k. The axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry is x equals to h. So axis of symmetry means it's the vertical line which cuts the curve into exactly two halves. Okay, so this line would be the axis of symmetry. Number four, that's domain. Domain is always the same. It's negative infinity to infinity, or you can say the whole real numbers. Range in this case would be if a is greater than zero. If we have a curve which opens upward, then the range would be k to the infinity, where we get k from this one. Okay, so that's k. And if a is less than zero, the range would be negative infinity up to k. Okay, now let us analyze this quadratic curve or this quadratic function. So here you can see that a equals to negative 2, b is 5, and c is negative 8. So the first thing is that we would write this function in terms of standard form. Okay. So for that, let us find out h is negative b by 2a, which is simply negative. B is 5, and 2 times a is negative 2. So that becomes 5 over 4. And k is simply f of h. Here h is simply 5 over 4. Let us plug in this 5 over 4 in this equation, in this expression. So that's negative 2. 5 over 4 whole square is 25 by 16. 4 square is 16. 5 square is 25. Plus 5 times 5 over 4 minus 8. Then this would be negative 50. By 16. So this is 25 by 4 minus 8 over 1. Okay, so we can write this as negative 50 over 16, and 4 times 4 is 16, so 25 is 100 minus 8. 8 times 16 is 122. K equals to negative 9 over. Thus, we obtained our vertex for this curve, which is vertex is 5 over 4, comma 9 over 2, negative 9 over 2. Axis of symmetry is x equals to 5 over 4. Since a equals to negative 2, which is less than 0, so curve opens downward. Okay. And number 4. Since a is less than zero, so range is simply negative infinity up to k. What is k? Negative 9 over 2. So that's all. Okay, these are the entire analysis that we can do. Let us draw the tentative curve. Okay, since we have already figured out the vertex, so we can write this curve in this standard form, which is y equals f of x equals a is negative 2, x minus h means x minus h is 5 over 4 whole square plus k. So k is negative 9 over 2. So that's our standard form. Okay, first of all, let us try to figure out the vertex of this curve, okay, which is 5 by 4, negative 9 over 2. 5 by 4 would be 1 whole number 1 by 4. So if this is 1, then this would be 5 by 4. Okay, this is 5 by 4. And negative 9 over 2 means it would be somewhere here. 4 and a half means it would be somewhere here. So this would be the point 5 comma 4. Negative 9 over 2. Okay, and our axis of symmetry, x equals to 5 by 4 would be this line, dotted line, something just like this. Since a is negative 2, we can think that curve goes downward in this way. Okay, so this would be the highest point, it would go in this way. But let us figure out what would be the y-intercept. For y-intercept, we would just set x equals to 0. In that case, if x equals to 0, then let us plug in this value in this equation. It's better to work with this equation in this case. So that would be y equals to, this is 0, this is 0, that's negative 8. So the curve will reach x-intercept somewhere here. So the curve will meet y-axis at the point x equals to negative 8. So this should be the tentative curve, okay? And by the idea of this axis of symmetry, the left-hand part will be reflected to right-hand, okay? So this would be the curve. So this is the tentative diagram of the curve, all right? So this is how we try to draw the graph of the curve once everything is found out. And you can see that the range also satisfies what we have seen here. Okay, so that's all.